everyone, this is Arun from Arun's Technology, and today we are going to know what is a submarine. So you can say this is a submarine, but what is it? So submarine is an is a boat that can go under the sea. So like if you can see, this is the sea. Normally what happens is boat sail like this. So if they sail on the top of the water, but what is in the case of submarine is, this is the sea, it goes inside the water like this. So it can go up to, there are many depths, the highest depth is 830 meters. So it is made by a Russian submarine, that is Oscar class. But now if you talk about Indian submarines, they can go from 350 to 450 meters in depth. That is more than 1000 feet. So let me just see this and tell you more about the submarine. So a submarine is very small in size. It is almost 83 to 93 meters in length, and it is around 15 to 20 meters in width. So in submarine, you can see there are many compartments. First, if we see, comes the torpedo room. So you can see there are torpedo rooms are in both the sides. But now you must be wondering, what is a torpedo? So torpedo is a kind of a underwater missile. Like you must have seen in warships or fighting airplanes. What they do is they launch the missile and then it goes and hits in the air. But what is a torpedo is, if you launch a torpedo from a submarine like this, inside, which is inside the water, let me just show you clearly. So if you think that this is the sea, here is the main submarine and here is the submarine which is the target. So what it will do is, it will launch a torpedo, which is an underwater missile. It will go and then it will destroy the submarine. So that is the use of a torpedo, like a missile destroys a ship or something. Like if you fire a bullet from a gun, what happens is that bullet goes and pierces through the wall or does some damage. So the same is a torpedo. And torpedoes are not fired manually. They are loaded into torpedo tubes. So like if this is a torpedo, it is loaded into a torpedo tube and then it is fired. So like that the torpedo is fired. Now if we move on to the next topic. But before that, if it is a normal torpedo submarine, it can carry 12 to 38 torpedoes. And if it is a ballistic missile submarine, like ballistic missile submarines are the submarines which can even fire missiles with torpedoes. So they can carry 12 to 24 torpedoes because they need to carry missiles too. So if you go to the next topic, that is the battery room. And this is the most confusion of normal people, that they think that submarine runs on diesel. But that is totally wrong. They have a battery room. So like whenever the submarine is on surface, they use this diesel engine to generate electricity and charge the batteries. When they die, they switch from diesel to battery, right? The diesel engine will be shut off and the battery will be on. And then the battery will be making the propeller run and make the submarine go forward. And if we see, there are many batteries. It's not like an inverter, a small inverter. There is a full battery room compartment. So you can see the image over here. I'll show it to you. And if you here, you can see this is the very, very important part of submarine. A periscope. So you might have seen in science, like you keep the periscope over here and you can see the things which are happening over here. So that is the periscope, that is also used in submarines. It is almost 20 to 30 meters long. The periscope is 20 to 30 meters long. Now if the submarine is at 250 meters depth, so it has to come up to 20 to 30 meters and then only it can use its periscope. So that is done. Let's do the next one. The next comes here is the main control room. So this is the main room of the submarine. Here the captain, the motor man, everyone sits here. And there's also a separate planning room. The kitchen is somewhere over here. And everything is here in the main control room and over here. So what happens is the discussions happen where the submarine has to go on which path it has to go. If here is a submarine which is already wrecked, means it is already destroyed, and it will go, then it will crash it and it will also get destroyed. So like it has to change path, it has to go like this. This all is discussed in the control room and the submarine is operated from here. So now you can see here something known as ballast tanks. So what are ballast tanks? Ballast tanks are, if a submarine is on the surface, like this is the sea and here is the submarine. So it will blow air into the ballast tank so that the weight of the submarine is less and it can float on water. And whenever it has to dive, so it will fill the ballast tanks with a lot of water. And then the pressure of the water is high and also the weight. And the submarine will go inside the water. As you can see, it has gone inside the water after blowing the ballast tanks up. And then inside it goes. And a submarine is the most important part of a navy, as it is known as a silent killer. Silent killer. Because this goes very quietly and only the propeller makes a lot of bubbles because it rotates. But nowadays nuclear submarines have come, so they make energy from uranium, you know that it's a metal. So that doesn't generate noise at all. Now, India has one submarine known as INS Arihant. And it is making another by the name INS Arighat. So INS Arighat and INS Arighat are already in Indian service. And India has one submarine which is taken on lease by Russia. So like from Russia, India has taken a submarine by the name INS Chakra. These are nuclear submarines. So this is taken by India with Russia in a lease of 10 years, which is going to expire in 2021. So India is taking another submarine in lease, and it is building these two. So this is already in service, and this will come into service by 2021. And other two nuclear submarines are under construction by India. So I'll erase this and tell you them more next. So now I am going to tell you what are the types of submarines. So now currently Indian Navy has 20 to 22 submarines, but now it will almost go till 40 by 2030 to 2040. So there are many types of submarines like nuclear, diesel electric. So these are the two types. So nuclear submarines make energy from uranium, and nuclear submarines are very powerful. If they fill up with 1 or 2 kilograms of uranium, they can easily be inside the water for around 10 to 20 years. They can easily be. And diesel electric submarines can only be for a short period of time, like 40 to 50 days. So that, but even though they have very powerful batteries inside the battery room, they need to be charged every 3 to 4 days. So what happens is, it will start a diesel engine. Okay, but how will it remove its smoke? Okay, so it will give out the bubbles. But how will it get oxygen? So it has to go to the surface. Then it will switch on the diesel engine, and 6 hours, 7 hours, it will charge the battery. And then again go down. But there is one problem. If the enemy's satellite from up detects it, it is very, very hard for the submarine to survive. So that's why there is a new system called AIP. It means Air Independent Propulsion. So what is the meaning of AIP is, the toilet which the submariners go, there are around 90 crew members in a submarine. So there is a bio toilet. So from that bio toilet, the whatever the toilet is gone, it is converted into oxygen and is given into this diesel engine, and it goes up in the meter of 20 to 30 meters, and it just picks up a small nozzle, and the smoke is removed from the submarine and the batteries are charged. With this technique, the submarine can be dived inside water for 45 to 60 days. So this is a very good system, and DRDO in India has made this. So this was my video for today. I hope you liked the video. Please like the video, share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe our channel.